Hi everybody, this is Holly over at Hot Humble Pie. Welcome if you're new, and a big warm hello to my subscribers. I love you guys so much. Well, I thought it was about time for another seriously free DIY vid. You gotta love those. So today I have four beautiful by the beach summer decor projects for you. And of course, as always, I hope you enjoy my video. And if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, I'd love it if you click that button. DIY number one. So this is my inspiration piece from Wayfair, and it really is, you know, an inspiration piece. Mine isn't identical, but that triggered an idea. I'm using lath. My lath was free, but if you want to buy it, it's almost free. It's $1.12 for 8 feet, and you can just drive to Home Depot. They'll cut it for you and put it in your trunk and you drive away. It is usually red. Sometimes you can find it in light colors, but if you're going to paint it, it doesn't matter. And because it's really thin, like kind of like a ruler, it is often the wood that breaks that ends up in their trash can. So I think the guy told me they lose about 20 pieces off of each stack that they get. So pretty regular free wood that you can pick up if your Home Depot or Lowe's manager is nice and not being weird about it. And for more information on how you can get free wood, I do talk about it in my first video, but every single store that sells wood invariably has wood that is free, because they have to. It gets damaged, it isn't sellable. It's just up to the individual managers whether or not they're going to give that to you for free or throw it away, but it is what it is. I will tell you, for the Home Depot manager that does that for me, I am a hardcore patron. That is the only Home Depot that I buy stuff at. I go out of my way, so I encourage you guys to do the same. It's a nice way to say thank you. So here I'm mixing some paint up. It's just brown paint. You can use whatever paint you want, but I want these to look stained, and I'm trying to copy the inspiration picture. And I made my anchor and starfish the same way that I made my Pottery Barn dupe faux wooden beads. For those of you that haven't watched that video, I will link it at the end of this video, and I will also put it down in my description box. But I'm dabbing it on with a baby wipe, and in the end, you guys, I figured out that just painting it on first and dabbing it off was better, and I didn't really need a baby wipe. I could have just done it with paper towels, but live and learn. So just use a paper towel, that's fine. In fact, these little guys here really prefer not to get wet, so paper towel is probably more optimal. I end up having to blow dry them, which is fine. Everything worked out okay, but it was one extra step that you won't need to do if you use a paper towel. So I'm also going to be taking my favorite color, black paint. For those of you that watch my video again, you guys know I love black paint for weathering, and I'm going to make everything look old and beaten up and dirty, like it's been outside. So now I'm laying out all of my pieces here to kind of get a feel for how I want it to look. And I decide that I'd rather not have uniformity with two broken ends on either side. Even though my inspiration piece is like that, I like it better when it's uneven, because that's how it would really be with a real sign at the beach. They break unevenly and, you know, get beaten up differently from the salt air. So I wanted to make sure mine look that way too. And I'm just taking more black paint now, and I'm edging the starfish and the anchor to make it look all old and distressed as well. And here I'm just using the jute twine from Walmart. It's a little thicker, and I'm going to wrap it around the anchor and make it look like the rope that would be on an anchor. And for those of you that don't have any jute twine, you can look around and use an old shoelace. I've also taken white t-shirts before, cut them super, super wafer thin, and then twisted them around and around in a coil and soaked them in like a tea or watered down brown paint. And it looks awesome, actually. It looks the same. So use your imagination and have fun. Of course, because the edges are raw wood, I'm going to take my wood glue here. I talk about the benefits of wood glue in depth in many of my videos, but basically, you guys, if you're going to glue raw wood together, just trust me, use wood glue, because it becomes part of the wood. And I'm using my hot glue in between to tack it on so that it stays in place while I'm crafting. And I do decide to give a little extra support to these on the back. So I take some craft sticks, I cut off the ends because they're a tad bit longer, and I glue them on the back. And for those of you that are wondering how I got those pieces all broken and jagged looking, I stepped on those puppies. I did. I just put some flip-flops on, stepped on them, and snapped them. It was super easy, and it came out perfect. I think I just broke off little pieces here and there to get it just right, but came out great. Just using a little hot glue here to glue these down. It works perfectly, no complaints. And here it is, you guys, and I absolutely love this. I really do. They're adorable. I hope the camera does them justice. They're free. You can't beat free. For those of you that don't have access to free wood and can't get lath right now, check out my video on how to make a faux wood plank. That'll be at the end of this video as well, and in the description box. That'll help you guys out, get it almost down to free. But that's it. I love these, and so moving on. But before we move on, today's video is another special one because this video is in collaboration with Kat over from According to Kat, another one of my favorites, and I'm guessing a lot of you probably already know her. She was the first big channel to stumble on mine and say wow, wow, wow to me and subscribe. It's really hard being the new kid on YouTube, and that meant the world to me. So I love Kat. She's extremely talented. I've been following her since she started her channel, and her channel showcases a beautiful variety pack of DIYs. I mean, she doesn't just stick to one look. She does farmhouse, boho, modern, and then some. So after this video, please head on over to Kat for some more crafting fun and tell her I said hi. DIY number two. So here's my inspiration piece, but I wanted to make it nautical. So I saw another piece, and the trick was to put it together. And again, I'm using my free wood. These are called dunnage blocks. For those of you that watch my video on Seriously Free DIYs number two, I made a ladder using these. They're very distinct. They have that groove in there, and that's where the little forklift thing goes in there when they're lifting up big pallets of plywood. I did have to sand it down, but that was it. I can't complain. This particular dunnage block was unusual in that it was a perfect square, so I was saving it. I only got one, but I knew that it was unique, and I knew that I was going to be able to use it for something special. And when I saw those photos, I knew exactly what I was going to use them for. So now I'm taking wood glue, a little bit more on wood glue since I have, you know, some time here. At a molecular level, it bonds and becomes one with the grain of the wood. So very powerful hold, optimal glue to use with wood, raw wood. You know, if you've got your wood covered in thick paint or a polyacrylic or something, it's no good. It's got to be right on the raw wood. But great, great glue. I would use super glue second if I didn't have wood glue. That's probably the next best hold along with the hot glue. And I don't know how these gals do it on YouTube, you guys. I've seen people use E6000. When I use that, it soaks into the wood, but I've seen videos where girls are saying that they use that. Now, here I'm gonna wrap around, and I said it wrong in my last video, you guys. It's sisal rope, not sisal. So I'm correcting it now, sisal. Sisal rope, I'm gonna wrap it around and give it that nautical feel. Definitely wait for your glue to dry all the way before moving on, but here it is, you guys. And see that little yellow piece of wood glue at the bottom there? I sanded that off. These high definition cameras are amazing. They show things that you don't see in real life, and I don't wear glasses either. But anyway, I'm going to be using the little shelves here. I've got them staged with a starfish for a candle and a mermaid. Might keep the starfish. He's pretty cute though. But I hope that you go get your free wood and you get to enjoy doing this craft too. DIY number 3. So here's my inspiration piece, you guys. $15.99 for a pile of rocks. And here's the actual beach where we picked our rocks. And, you know, my husband and I went. We picked driftwood up, shells, lots of fun. And here's the rocks that I ended up washing off. You can tell they're heavy there. I'm trying to move them off the table gracefully. And the color blues I'm going to be using. So I'm just going to be lightly, these blues are pretty intense. So even though I'm lightly touching the rock, I'm still going to get quite a bit of color coming off. You know, they did a study on blues and they found it's a calming color. So I think that's why you probably see it in hospitals and preschools and classrooms. I know I met a teacher once who said she purposely chose the blue big poster paper to put on the bulletin board to keep her, you know, she thought maybe it helped to keep her students calmer so she'd have less behavioral problems. So blue is really calming. It's perfect for an ocean decor piece. And I'm just giving it three different colors. I thought that'd be really pretty to do almost like a, you know, it's not going to be exactly like the inspiration piece because that was just meant for inspiration. I'm going to make it my own and I am going more for the ombre effect. An E6000 works great on rocks, you guys. So there I am, I'm putting three big dots of E6000. I'm putting the hot glue on to hold it in place. And then I remember I forgot to write my word on it. Yep. I had taken the word off my inspiration piece and blown it up a little bit and traced it for my computer screen. That's a nice little tip. For those of you that watch my videos, you've heard me say that before. I often trace my computer screen. Perfectly safe as long as you don't press too hard, and it's a great way to save ink and paper. And this beach is just another word. I think I actually looked up nautical stuff and the word beach came up and I went, oh, that's pretty. And I traced that one. And I'm using my black painter's pen. The painter pen that I am using is below in my description box if you're interested. It works really, really well and it lasts a long time. And I'm just filling in these words. And I also decide that these need a little bit of dry brushing with white paint. I want to make them look scratched, but I also thought it would be fun to try and imitate the white foam of the ocean. And time for more E6000 and gluing. And I want to tell you guys, once I put the hot glue on, this instantly bonded. It's super heavy. I was able to turn it sideways and write that word on it. It was amazing. And here's a shell I had. I thought that would be so pretty on the front. I love mine better than the one from Hobby Lobby. And you did not need E6000 either with the shell, just hot glue. So maybe hot glue and rocks go together really well, but everything worked great. And there she blows, everybody. Mother Nature provided everything for this. You can't beat that, except the paint. And again, the high definition camera's about to show some glue here. You also can't see that. The top rock provides shadows. I swear it's hidden. This came out so, so cute. DIY number 4. You're going to need a bottle and some corks and some old-fashioned writing. Now, the only thing I could think of was our U.S. Constitution that had the kind of old-fashioned handwriting that I wanted. And I'm just going to roll the title up on the inside so you won't see that. Now, if you want to see that, you could use this, I guess, as a 4th of July decoration. But for now, I'm using it for beach decor, so I'm going to roll it up on the inside. Here I am edging it with the color Burnt Umber from Apple Barrel Paint, and I'm just making it look nice and old. For those of you that watch my videos, you know that I love masking tape, especially for putting it down first to make a surface a little bit more, I guess, adhesive for hot glue, because hot glue often doesn't like to stick on shiny surfaces. And I've used it for years and I have found it works great, but you can use whatever sticky kind of tape, you know, as long as it has a good stick, you can use whatever you want for this. And I'm just taking the twine from the Walmart and wrapping it up around at the top, and I do end up going down a little bit longer on the other end as well. Using a lighter to burn off the extra long hairs and fuzz. The amount of times that you wrap it around and around is going to vary from project to project, depending on what size bottle you use and how much twine you have left. But you start it by a thin strip of glue at the top and you end it with a thin strip of glue. And then you're going to see me right here put glue in a vertical direction. And then I turn it and I press the string into it so that my cork will hang downwards in a vertical position. And in a minute, you're going to see me dump some really beautiful turquoise sand in this bottle that I have left over for some sand paintings that I did many years ago. There it is, absolutely beautiful, perfect for a nautical decor piece. You just tuck that little message in the bottle, and I have a leftover tassel from a boho project that I did. I made two tassels and I only ended up using one, and I thought it would be perfect for this bottle. And that's it. This is actually almost like a boho beach bottle, but I love this. It's beautiful and it's so simple. And again, if you don't have the jute twine, use an old t-shirt, cut super thin, soaked in tea, wrapped, or an old shoelace. Just be creative and have fun. A big thank you to Kat for inviting me to collab with you. It has been so much fun. And until the next video, breathe deep, fret not, and do things that make you happy.